Yankee, Zulu, Yankee. Got to be the last in the ICAO airport designator list. A call sign like that. Still as empty as last summer. But all white now. Mount Morphy in the distance. Can't wait to be up there buzzing the microwave towers. My Searey, hopefully this summer. I was hoping to get inside my hangar today from the field side for the first time in a long time, but the sliding doors are frozen shut, so another challenge for another day. They never let up. That's what the fun's all about, I suppose. So let's go see what's happened in Hangar X since the last video I shot last summer. The spirit lives, or maybe be more accurate to say that she's in the gestation period. You can see I've made quite a bit of progress since last July when I was at the stage of waiting for the government inspector to come. Do his inspection, sign off on the pre-cover, which then allowed me to start closing in the fuselage. You can see the turtle deck there with the rear windows underneath the pylon. And I started doing the fabric covering. You can see the rudder mounted there. That's the only flying surface actually mounted on the fuselage. The others are over here. The two wings under their plastic protective wrap, waiting for the warm weather of spring to come so I can continue with the poly spray, being the dope, so to speak, that covers the fabric and prior to doing the painting. And those are the flaps and the ailerons in those long packages there in the forefront. You can also see in the background here, I've made some progress with filling up my wall of fame. Over here, I'm looking at ideas for the paint scheme. Lots of pictures I pulled off the internet of other people's paint schemes for inspiration. Oh, my call sign. When I got the pre-cover done, I was eligible to register and get my registration numbers. Charlie, Golf, Mike, Kilo, Romeo. The idea with this three view of Searey for paint layout drawing on the wall is that with magic markers, myself and my hangar guests can color up. I think what I'm going to do is use the color scheme and the flag that's proposed for Canada's 150th birthday celebration next year. I've actually been in some communication with the bureaucratic office in Ottawa that would allow me to use the copyrighted logo. But since we had an election last fall, the bureaucracy seems to have shut down. So I'm still waiting to hear from them. And also some mementos from my trip last summer to Oshkosh. And then another trip flying a school plane down from Maryland to the Progressive Aerodyne factory in Tavares, Florida. And then over here, the unpacking of all my goods from my travels over the last 10 years around the world. Lots of memories and good feelings about my stuff. Good pig. Okay. Back to the plane. So, that's the cabin heater there. Runs off the water coolant for the engine and the battery box. The twin side-by-side seating. And then the rear bulkhead with the gear actuators for the main landing gear and the tail wheel. And you can see in there the plastic fuel tank. And a little unclear, but certainly I've installed the fuel system with a gascalator, that bright blue part down there in the lowest point in the hull, a priming bulb to allow me to pump out the sump of the gas tank overboard through that little connection. Over on the other side is the fuel filter. And in front of it and behind the main bulkhead down there is the electric fuel pump. This is the baggage compartment. There's some carpeted panels that fit on top of those foam blocks. And up in there, a little difficult to see, is the electromechanical actuator for the flaps. And the one down there is the actuator for the trim. I'm just working now on the pylon coverings. The pylon being a structure to mount the engine and the wings. And later today I'll be taking out all those plecos and replacing them with rivets. You can see that the turtle deck is now riveted down to the hull. And this side of the pylon is also ready to have its shroud riveted in place today. Now, the bow deck will be installed, at least temporarily, fairly soon as well. This is it over here, where I've mocked it up with the aluminum face plates for the instrumentation. On the left is the Nine-On Skyview mock-up. That's the engine and flight information system screen. And in the center will be where the communication, the radios, switches, etc. will mount. And on the co-pilot side will be where the airspeed indicator and the magnetic compass will mount. And when it's all said and done, the flight deck will look something like that. Now, hooking all these instruments, avionics, together with the electrical switches and everything that they actuate and all the sensors that they read, I've purchased a wiring harness from ACI in the States. That has just arrived. I've got it still in my home where I'm checking out the continuity of all the wires and the labeling and trying to come to an understanding of what exactly it is. And then it'll mount above the rudder pedals from side to side of the hull. And that will be just behind the dashboard, so to speak, which is built into that fiberglass hull deck we were just looking at. So all in all, I'm pretty pleased with my progress. I'd hoped to be a little further along at this point, but over the last couple of months, I've not been able to put as many hours in as I did previously. Because I was blessed with a promotion at work. And that seems to be distracting me a little bit. But anyway, I'm still relatively hopeful I'll at least be doing taxiing tests by the middle of this summer, and perhaps we'll even get the test flying going before another winter season comes in. So, another installment of The Spirit of Mackenzie is in the can. And I hope to be giving you another progress report in a couple of months. And at that point, hopefully I'll have a spray gun in hand, applying some paint, doing some final wiring. The engine will be mounted. And the Spirit will be making some noise, if not some movement. So